Hello and good to see you again on this course looking at commodity spread trading and the possibilities that it can give you. In the previous videos, we have explained some of the immense potential that the spread technique can provide. We've also said that it's important to build up your knowledge and understanding of both the spread techniques and the market in general before starting to trade. So in this, the third segment, divided as always into two videos, we will start to look at and learn some of the fundamental analysis that you should always undertake when looking to identify possible trades so that you can begin to use it to your advantage in trading commodity spreads. We will begin to understand two very important concepts in the world of commodities, or more precisely in respect to the futures we use when trading commodity spreads, those concepts being contango and backwardation. You may never have heard of these before. Don't worry, I hadn't either before I started my trading career. What we will look at in this session is what these concepts are and how we can start to apply the learnings to spread trading. As you're probably aware, in most cases, futures with different maturities have different prices. In commodities, most frequently, the price of the closest future is lower than those of the further dated ones. This situation is the norm and is referred to as contango. This condition occurs for raw materials due to the fact that producers have to pay costs for things such as storage, maintenance of their products, and these are higher for the longer dated maturities. This in turn is reflected in the price of the related futures contracts. As an example, think of a cattle farmer. The cost of keeping cattle until December rather than June would be higher due to the need to feed the herd for the extra 6 months. Then take into consideration the additional costs for things like shelter, insurance and vet bills, you can begin to see why it costs more to keep the cattle for longer. The same goes for all other commodities that must be preserved, stored or nurtured. This is not the case for traditional financial products. In fact, it's just the opposite. The shorter maturities are more expensive than the longer dated ones. If we look at stocks and shares, for example, because there are no costs associated with owning them and having possession of them generates income by way of a dividend paid, the demand and therefore the price of something that generates an actual return is greater in the near term compared to that of the longer term. Returning to commodities, it's possible that due to geopolitical or climatic factors, contango may be lost. That is to say, the price for futures on raw materials closest to the maturity can over time become more expensive than the further dated contracts. This abnormal and unforeseen situation is called backwardation, and in part is due to the external factors, where supply and demand for given commodities are unbalanced at certain periods of time. The duration of this situation may differ depending on the severity of events that have caused it. Now, as explained, the norm in the commodities market is contango, where the price of the shorter dated future is lower compared to that of the longer dated one. When demand and supply are balanced, markets are normal, or in contango. When demand is weak and supply is excessive, markets tend to amplify the contango and the far dated futures price move even higher compared to the near term ones. In the case of excess demand, the markets tend to reduce the contango and the price of the longer dated futures begin to move downwards closer to the nearer maturity until eventually they reverse the curve, thus sending it backwards. In the exceptional situation where we experience backwardation, we see that the price of the longer dated future moves lower than that of the near one, as excessive demand compared to supply affects the price. The backwardation curve is potentially unlimited, i.e. the difference between the near futures price and the far off future tends to theoretically be infinite. The shape of the futures curve is important for speculators and investors who want to cover themselves against risk by purchasing raw materials. It provides important information on the state of the raw material on the market, both at the present date and in the coming months. A backwardation state, for example, may suggest in the near term a shortage of supply that pushes the current price upwards, or it may be the result of a forecast of a generous supply in the future that causes the price to drop in the longer term. This slide shows an example of both backwardation and contango in futures pricing. In the top example, we can see that the near price of corn for the July 13 contract is $655. Whilst the price for the longer dated March 14 contract is $540. As the price for the longer dated contract is lower than that for the near dated future, we would say the market is in backwardation. Conversely, in the lower example, we see the normality of contango, where the July 13 price for wheat is lower than that for the July 14 contract. Let's look at an example of backwardation on the cotton market. This chart shows information on a spread we've created using July 17 and December 17 contracts. The black line represents precisely the trend of this spread. The horizontal blue line, value 0, represents the point where the spread moves from contango to backwardation. Where the value of the spread is a minus figure, this shows we are in contango, where the price of the July contract is lower than that of December. Where the value crosses the blue line and turns positive, we would say that we're in backwardation, where the December future is lower than that of the closer July one. We can see that for the majority of the period shown, the spread was in backwardation and that this was amplified in the second week of May when the positive differences increased. The period immediately after this could be classed as returning towards contango. Although we did not reach or pass through zero, the downward movement showed a levelling out of the price before the two prices making up the spread began to diverge again. This is just one example of a market in backwardation, and we can learn how to exploit these anomalies to our advantage. Unlike a share or a currency, when two related products, or as in this case, when two futures of the same raw material begin to diverge greatly in terms of price, a realignment is inevitable and presents an opportunity to exploit the corrective movement. In order to better understand the situation, let's have a look at what's happened in the past. So, using the spread from the previous slide on cotton, we can see here information relating not only to 2017, but to the preceding years. The price where we move between contango and backwardation is still zero. This never changes. We can see that for the majority of the years, the spread has maintained normality. But there are some years, namely 2004, 2010, 2011 and 2014, where a situation of backwardation has existed. On each occasion, we can see that there was a realignment where the spread returned to normal. And in the case of 2011, where we experienced amplified backwardation, the realignment happened rapidly. Normal market conditions, contango, will take into account the cost associated with the business of producing and storing the raw materials. Hence the reason why the near-end prices tend to be lower, as these costs are lower compared to those where commodities need to be stored or produced in the longer term. Exceptional circumstances that lead to excessive supply or reduced demand can change the normal equilibrium, leading to fluctuations in the market and a changing direction of prices, leading to backwardation. This leads to opportunities where we can benefit from the changes in trends and prices, as well as the corrections that will ultimately follow. In addition to exploring contango and backwardation, we've started to look at and use examples of the charts, graphs and information that we have at our disposal. By taking the data that we have and inputting into our trading platform, we can begin to create a picture of the possible opportunities that exist to create effective spread trades. In the next episode, we will further explore the fundamental analysis that builds the basis for identifying, analysing and ultimately executing effective spread trades. More specifically, we will look at seasonality and the impact that this has on commodities. I look forward to speaking to you soon. Bye for now.